All right, we're going to do some street maths here in the outdoors, which I've heard a lot about. But first, my shoe is untied, so we need to fix that. Now, most people would mess around doing some kind of complicated knot. Not me, I'm a mathematician. I've got maths to do. Grab the two sides, pass them over, boom, there's your knot. Again, in slow-mo. I've heard about it, you know, on the math circuit. People would discuss the way that you tie your shoes, right? And so I know it's been around for a long time. I know it's been passed down from mathematician to mathematician, but I'm not familiar with the earliest case. And I have heard names assigned to it, but I've not come across any one that particularly sticks. I just call it that brilliant way to tie your shoes.
Be honest with me, is that how you do your shoes?
I do genuinely tie my shoes up that way. I know I'm always talk the talk, but I literally tie my shoes that way up to once a day. Once it's done, looks exactly the same, right? So some people will go, that's an unusual knot, right? But if they actually see it happening, it's like they've seen a magic trick, right? People, it blows their minds. They can't comprehend how a knot can happen so quickly, but I'm not startled. I'm a mathematician. I know what I'm doing. Okay, you go from completely undone, starts the same way as a normal knot. You do a little foundation thing, which in maths is called a trefoil. It has a minimum of 3 crossings, that particular knot. Now, to tie the actual bow, you get one shoelace that's coming up the back. You fold it forward and you hold it on its way down. So it goes up over the loop and then down. This one curls back in the opposite direction. And again, you hold it on the way down. And then all you do is you take this one on the way down and put it under that loop at the same time as taking this one and putting it under that loop. And then you swap them over to the other hands and then you pull them tight. And that is your knot. And with a little bit of practice, once you tighten it, hold them on the way down, cross, pull, knot. So the one that comes at the back, you fold it forward into a loop and then you hold it on the way down. So it goes up and then on the way down, you're grasping it. Same with this one, except it goes back. So it starts at the front, curls back, hold it on the way down. Now you're going to take this lace, put it under that loop, at the same time as taking this lace and putting it under that loop. So they go past each other, they swap hands, you pull it tight, and there's your knot. People tie their shoelaces, they get one in, they loop the other one around, they pull it through, which is the normal way. Although I notice, of course, Brady wears slip-ons.
Oi, what's wrong with that?
For those of us who have entered adulthood, we do it a long, complicated way. But the thing is, you end up with a knot that holds your shoe on. That's the goal here.
My shoelaces form what ordinary people would think a knot. Now, nothing of this is a mathematical knot because it has loose ends. If it has loose ends, you can, in principle, untie it, and you can form a different knot.